Okay, guys, so we're going to go through episode 2, as we're kind of calling it, of Morning After Mobility. This is the double band in the rack stretch. Reason that I kind of came across this one, and I use it very much, is a lot of times, you know, when you're doing the normal hamstring, you know, stretch, or you're trying to do a stretch, a lot of times people are only going to be feeling it behind the knee or high up, or a little bit in the middle. Ideally, when you're stretching out a muscle, you should be able to feel relief throughout the whole range of motion and the whole length and breadth of the muscle. So what this has kind of done is taken away you personally having to hold yourself in the stretch, which a lot of times will force you to tense up. This allows you to relax. It also gives you a little bit of a pull from the hip. We're gonna choke a band low onto the rig, and that's gonna kind of pull that hip back a little bit, which is gonna allow your full hamstring to kind of release and get a big stretch. And we have one up here, which is gonna kind of anchor the top around your ankle, obviously both going different directions here. And it's just gonna create a really nice situation to really get a good relaxing, allow you to relax, allow that hamstring to kind of just open up and finally get some relief for you. So, bands, get them anywhere. Rogue, Elite Fitness, Iron Woody, you know, anywhere you can find them. This is about a 2-inch band or an average band, as you know, I kind of grew up in the West Side side of things, and this is called an average band, so I always refer to it as an average band. Using bands is going to be up to patient tolerance. I'm a bigger guy, I need a bigger band. If you're a smaller person, you may need a smaller band. But it's also going to depend on how much that actual tissue can take, so just keep that in mind, okay? So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to choke one low, okay? Choking, just taking it here, wrapping through the middle, choke just like that. I'm going to leave that go. Another band, same thing, different color, doesn't much matter. We're going to choke one right about hip height when you stand up. So I'm right about here. Just like this. Now, this is where the fun starts. I always recommend to take your shoes off, kick them off, kick off your Reeboks, and relax. So you're going to help get yourself down. Band here, kind of weave yourself in, pull it up as high as you can on that hip where it's not grabbing anything it shouldn't be, but it's got to grab something. You're going to lay back, allow it to open up a little bit more. If you have a partner, this is always a little bit easier, but you can do it yourself. Let's see if I can do it here. And there we go. What you're gonna do is move yourself in a position to where you're feeling a little bit of a pull here, but you're also gonna get a nice pull from the hamstring. And from there, you just lay back, let the bands do the work. That's what's wonderful about the bands. You don't have to tense up and try to yank or pull on anything. It just kind of is what it is. Now, you're not getting the stretch that you want more, wrap it around the pole again, get a bigger band. Too much, go to a lighter band, okay guys? So you're gonna kind of hang here, you can kind of move a little bit, get a little bit more of a hip swing going on, kind of push your knee straight, internally, externally rotate your hip, find out where it's tight for you, and go after that. Again, we're gonna recommend 2 to 5 minutes or patient tolerance. Like right now, I can start to feel my foot tingle a little bit. That either means that the band is on something it shouldn't be, so I'll move that, or it's just gonna start to get a little bit too tight for me. So I'm gonna move around a little bit so I can talk to you guys and be all right with it. If it's too much, obviously it's time to switch. It's okay, sometimes you're gonna have to start off really, really slowly and build these things up. So obviously this is gonna be great for any time, but in particular, anything that you do for your posterior chain when you're doing lower body deadlifts, if like deadlifts doing some squatting, something along those lines. Anything that's going to irritate that hamstring that we want to go ahead and correct, that's where this is going to come in. All right, guys, so that's episode 2. We'll move on from here. Thanks for watching. See if we can get out of this.